capable of transporting unreal amounts of electricity at unprecedented speeds with little to no electric losses. They are big, they are fast, they are the modern superheroes of electricity, they are the superconductors. But the great tale of superconductivity is complex, and its origins started many years ago. And in this episode of What's What, we are going to take a look at the history of superconductors, examine how they evolved, then show you why they are so super. But before we get started, subscribe below, leave us a comment, or give us a like. Energy depends on it. The story begins a century before the energy operation of today, when physicist Kamerlingh Onnesch first succeeded in liquefying helium. With his Dutch team, Onnesch developed a program to measure the properties of matter at very low temperatures. In 1911, Onnesch found that mercury, as an electric transmitter, shows zero electric resistance once reaching 4.2 Kelvin or minus 269 Celsius degrees. This was the first time in history that a conductor was found to have zero resistance. Onnesch dubbed the phenomenon as superconductivity. Onnesch was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics for his discovery, the first of six prizes awarded to date for work on superconductors. I told you, they are super! Under specific conditions, or critical temperatures, the material can transform into a state which makes it a superconductor. Now, superheroes, I mean superconductors, have two specific properties, as my very super friend Athena is here to tell us.
Superheroes? Like space people? Cool!
Yes, Athena! Like you!
Superheroes, superconductors, doesn't even matter. What is matter? Or is it what's matter? Ah, never mind, doesn't even matter.
This is what I deal with every day.
So about those properties. As Frédéric mentioned in a previous episode, electric conductivity is measured by the rate which determines the transportation material level of resistance and losses. And so, the conductors lose or slow down electricity as it carries it from point A to point B. But oh no, not superconductors.
Right, Athena. This is what brings us to property number one. Superconductors have a zero resistance rate. What that means is electric current can flow through them without dissipating any energy. Then there is property number two, the Meissner effect. And this is a bit more complicated. Superconductors expel an external magnetic field which remains around their surface. Just another reason superconductors are so super. They literally go beyond the limits of classical physics. But what's the true purpose of all this magic, innovation, and power?
And I've got answers, Frédéric. Now, when a grid operator designs a facility, kind of like this one, to transport electrical power, they tend to raise the voltage to a really high amount. And we're talking like incredible Hulk-sized voltage here, people. The problem with that is when you have an increase in current, you tend to have an increase in losses as well. And this could lead to a lot of waste. Not good. And with standard conductors, achieving more efficient insulation requires larger and more expensive equipment. But have no fear, superconductors are here. Moderate voltage, high currents with zero electrical losses, no problem. That's what superconductors are made for. With superconductors, we transport electricity with cleaner, safer, and more efficient manner. But how are they made? Frédéric?
Let's compare a superconducting cable and a standard transmission cable side by side. They look pretty similar, don't they? But trust me when I say the superconducting cable is much more advanced. It may not look like it, but the modern superconducting cable is about as high-tech as Tony Stark's Iron Man suit. Actually, it may even transport more energy. Sorry, Mr. Stark. But one more thing. Superconductivity is only achieved if the operating material stays below a critical temperature. That's why it's super necessary to constantly maintain these cables cool using a cryogenic fluid. But that's not all. Each superconducting cable has a covering, an outer protective wall, an inner cryostat wall, a nitrogen coolant chamber, a copper shield for stabilization, a superconducting shield tape, a high voltage dielectric tape, and superconducting tapes around its core. All this stuff basically functions to keep the conductor temperature low and controlled. That way, high amounts of electricity can be transported safely. Am I right, Athena?
Correct. Now, super cables can be massive in length, and so they are transported on coiled drums. Now, to be installed, one end of the super cable is going to be connected to an open station, and then the drum is unrolled into underground ducts. And this operation requires real know-how. And laying cables is really no easy task, but it is definitely worth the effort. When it comes to coiling superconductors, keeping everything compact is key for installation purposes. One superconducting circuit can replace several standard circuits. That is how effective they can be. The absence of Joule losses and the regulated cooling of the actual superconducting cable make it pretty independent of its thermal environment, especially in severe climatic conditions, such as a dry ground and really high ambient temperatures, like out here in Texas. Now, superconductor systems can be buried in congested soil, which means that you don't have to really worry about how deep it needs to go or how far away from nearby infrastructures or buildings it needs to be. Whereas standard transmission systems, you have to worry about that because one little thing can disturb the entire power grid. But with superconductors, you don't have to worry about that, which makes them so much more versatile. Now, superconductors have become widely accepted and publicly available. And because of this, it's actually so much easier for them to be created and to be put out in so many different cities around the world. So this way, you don't have to have any delays for actually installing them, which another problem is that with standard transmission systems.
But Athena forgot one thing. Superconductors also have the ability to transmit high power at medium voltage, thus making room in the high voltage section and its transformers within a distribution network. In the case of the ampacity link with our Nexans project in Essen, Germany, a superconductor installation was able to free up a whole substation and thus commercial real estate for economic expansion while at the same time lessening greenhouse emissions.
But perhaps the coolest thing about superconductors is their power to control us all. But that's it for me, Frédéric. Back to you.
Superconducting cables are primarily used to transmit power in dense areas, but that's not all. For the LIPA project in New York, Nexans replaced an existing overhead line with safer, more efficient underground super cables. Both these projects were carried out by Nexans to ensure safer, more efficient transportation of energy. Nexans has also been exploring other possibilities, such as the future potential for electric highways. And as part of the EC-funded European Best Path project, a full-size superconductor demonstration was validated, with impressive features, including a current rating of 10,000 amps. The objective of this project was to develop the feasibility of insulated cable technology for the transmission of 3 gigawatts on a continent. And 3 gigawatts equals the power generated by 3 nuclear reactors or 300 huge offshore wind turbines. That's what we do with our heroes of electric transportation, the superconductors save energy yet again. Now, for a quick review, remember, superconductivity started with Kamerlingh Onnes in 1911. At given temperatures, certain conductors had absolutely no resistance. Superconductors expel an external magnetic field which remains around their surface, known as the Meissner effect. Cumulatively, zero losses allow for faster and safer transportation of electricity. Superconducting cables are much more versatile and efficient than regular cables. Superconducting cables are complex and still expensive, but their design ensures maintenance of the essential temperatures and conditions. Superconducting cables require special skills, and few companies around the world are equipped to install them. Levitating trains, particles accelerators, nuclear fusion, we have thousands more amazing stories to tell you about superconductivity. But that's the end of our first season of What's What. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much to you followers. We will be back for season 2.
Yay!
In the meantime, do not hesitate to watch again previous episodes and to give us your comments and suggestions. If you follow me from the beginning of this adventure, you will remember that I'm not a full-time YouTuber. I actually work for a leading cable company committed to promoting sustainable energy, Nexans. Nexans' purpose is to electrify the future. Electrification is in our DNA and has been for the last 120 years. By 2024, Nexans will become the first electrification pure player of its industry, being the operational link from generation of energy to transmission, distribution, and usage. For sure, there will be much more electrifying topics to come on What's What channel, so stay tuned!